You think you know me?
Whom should I show my poem to? Hello everyone, welcome back to Doki Doki Let's check out the Relapse. Doki Doki Relapse is... what is this called? I don't... actually, no. Back to main menu. Okay, Doki Doki Relapse, that's the name of this mod. And we are back. Well, I'm back. I'm really full right now, so I may or may not throw up during this. Because I've overeaten again. But alas, we'll just see how it goes. Whom should I show my poem to? Well, we spent time with Yuri. And we spend time with Sayori, so I think we'll just go with Natsuki. Oh, start off with Natsuki. Sup, Natsuki? Ugh, you again? Ah, I'm happy to see you too. Where the fuck is my drink? It seems more hostile than usual. Is it because I spent time with Yuri? Guess that means it's time to be a kiss ass. Listen, I know that you're a poem writing expert and all. But maybe you could pull some punches, just this once. Heh, no chance. And don't think that bothering me up will make me go easy on you. Sigh. Very well, I suppose I am at your mercy. I bow my head as I pull the poem out of my folder. Here, I'm willing to endure your judgment. Path.
The path. A skip in my steps marks a new day, where not even the clouds appear to be grey. But as I jump along, continuing my path, I can't help but wonder, where is it that I'm going? My eyes are clear and the air is pure, so why can't I see what lies ahead? It could be candy and games, strawberries and sweets, if only I could see that which I chase. But instead of stopping my trip, I continue for a while. Even though I can feel sadness brewing, I can't help but smile.
I watch as she reads my poem. She seems to be acting the same way she did when I showed her my poem last week. Maybe that means she really likes it. Lopsa. Or maybe not.
Yes?
Why did you write this?
What?
Well, it's clear that there's a message in this poem, but why did you use these words? I take it that means that you didn't like it.
It's not that, it's just... I'm confused as to why you chose to use words like this.
Oh, well, that's an easy one. My time with Natsuki last week granted me some confidence in talking to her.
Huh?
Remember when I told you yesterday that I think that simple writing that expresses a strong idea is impressive? Well, I had a hunch that you might write that down too, so I tried my hand at it to see if I was any good. So I guess the reason I used words like that was because I had you in mind.
Gross!
I mean your poems. Don't go and start making things weird.
I just want to make things weird.
Well, that is to be expected of a weirdo, I believe is what you called me.
Heh, it looks like I was pretty good judge. I was a pretty good judge of character after all.
Ha ha, don't go flattering yourself before I've even read what you wrote.
Like that will change anything.
It is the best one here.
She seems to have more confidence in her writing than this time.
I hope it's not because she thought mine was bad.
I reckon I'll be the judge of that.
You know what, I'm not gonna read this again. For the 500th time or something.
I can see why she questioned my word choice. I had forgotten just how simple and to the point her writing is. Maybe I can simplify my next one more.
So, pretty amazing, huh? As much as I hate to inflate your ego,
I'll admit this is pretty good. Only pretty good. Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? Well, let's see. I proceed to push my imaginary glasses up my face, up on my face, and begin speaking in my most Sherlock Holmesy voice. It appears that this poem represents the feeling of a discouragement after seeing the actions of others. The feeling of giving up, if you will. There also appears to be a setup for a rhyme that, if my guess is correct, falls flat on purpose. Likely to snap the reader out of the poem. All in all, it's quite an impressive work. That concludes my analysis. Wow. You really are a weirdo. Ugh. I just can't win, can I? Nope. I let out a sigh, pick up my poem. Hey, Natsuki. You never actually told me if you like my poem or not. Huh? Oh. Yeah, it's not bad. But let me guess, it's not as good as yours. Well, what do you expect? I am the master, after all. Then perhaps one day. I bow down for Natsuki, which only puts me up at about eye level with her. I can be as good as you, Sensei. Well, you have potential, but it will take a lot more work to be this good. Thank you, Sensei. Your fate means a lot to me. It always makes me happy to see her let her guard down like this. Don't worry, Natsuki. I'll figure something out. I promise. I put my poem back in the folder and I'm on to the next. Yuri. Hey, Yuri. Hello again. I take that you wish to exchange poems. Yep, clever as always, I see. As Yuri tries to repress her plush, I pull the poem on purpose so that she doesn't see inside it. So, should you share first? As I ask this, I can't help but feel a little nervous. She is probably the most critical when it comes to this stuff. Well, I suppose I could share first if you are nervous. Am I really that bad at hiding my feelings? I understand, since you might not have much experience writing poetry. Perhaps reading mine will make you feel more comfortable. This girl, she really is something else. Thanks, Yuri, that means a lot to me. It's the least I can do. You aren't the blah blah blah. That cute laugh. God, I hope she likes my poem. Here. Oh. And sorry about my bad handwriting. Yeah, the ghost under light. We've also seen that many times. It's the same pose as last time, though I guess that makes sense since there's no reason for it not to be. In fact, I'm glad it is. It'll be easier to discuss this way. If you're having trouble reading it, I can tell you what it says. If you want. Oh, don't worry, Yuri. I didn't have any trouble reading it. I guess I was just awestruck, you know? Awestruck? Yeah, I mean, this poem is so good, how could I not be? The way you managed to capture the feeling of clinging on to that last place of comfort. The inability to let go of the past and how it will lead to being left with nothing. It's, well, it's amazing. Yuri's face is so red at this point that I'm afraid it might catch her hair on fire. It's nothing really. It's not as good as you say it is. Come on. Do I look like the kind of person to lie about things like this? Damn, wasn't expecting that. Sorry, I didn't mean to raise my voice. Even though she's basically just shouted at me, she's still so precious. Don't worry about it, Yuri, I was only joking. I know you don't think I'm insincere. I flash her a smile to try and reassure her. I didn't mean what I said about your poem, though. You should be proud of it. I suppose. Even though I'm sure it pales in comparison to yours, you can read mine now. If you want to, that is. Of course, it just slipped my mind. Sorry. Apology accepted. I smile as I hand over my poem.
Endless night. The ambient darkness holds my breath, my destiny slowly eroding around me. I dare not fret though, for this world is a world of my choosing. This cage, known as eternity, frees no captives. A place where pleasure is a sensation that is long since forgotten. What is the purpose of dreaming in a world where inferno is the only judgment? Perhaps this place does hold that one which I seek, but why pursue something that can never really be obtained?
About 2 minutes have passed, Yuri has yet to say anything. Maybe she doesn't like it and just doesn't know how to tell me. After about 30 more seconds, I finally decide to break the silence. So... Yuri snaps to life as though she just came out of trance. This poem, it's not bad, is it? No! Sorry, I mean... I give her some time to collect herself. She finally lets out a deep breath and begins to speak. Lopsa, I'm not sure how else to say this, but this poem... Shit, here it comes. It's exceptional! Woohoo! Score 1 for Lopsa. The way you managed to portray the feeling of helplessness, of never being able to acquire what you desire... Yuri pulls the sheet of paper up to cover her face. It was really good. The way she says that sounds almost provocating. I suddenly feel heat on my face, which I tried to hide by looking at my feet. Thanks, Yuri. Hearing that you liked my poem makes me feel a lot better about writing poetry. You're welcome. Oh, and one question if I may. Sure, ask away. Well, it's just that there seemed to be a lot of emotion here. I was just wondering what the inspiration was. If you want to tell me, that is. Inspiration? I don't really know. Sure, I read over it a couple of times, but I just thought it was something that she would like. Is there really a lot of emotion behind it? I suppose I'm still trying to piece that together. I see. And thanks for sharing, Lopsa. I certainly look forward to seeing what you have for tomorrow. Same here. Sayori! Howdy, Cinnamon-Bun. Hey, Lopsa. Did you remember to write a poem? Why, of course. I wouldn't want to embarrass the vice president in front of your club. So does this mean I get to read it now? I certainly don't see why not. I feel uneasiness creep as I pull a paper out of my folder. This poem came out a little dark. I know she says it liked them bittersweet, but this one's a bit much. Plus it's obvious even to me that it kinda describes her. Maybe she won't... It's alright if you're nervous. After all, it can't be any worse than the first poem that I wrote. I guess I don't have much of a choice. Thanks for the words of encouragement, Sayori, and here's my poem.
Repair. A single rose in a bed of flowers. Endless bliss that feels like a daydream. Another day for another adventure, but what is love without misfortune? I see the darkness behind the cheer, a rainbow that shines across the tears. A wonderful smile that hides the pain. An empty joy that begins to wane. But all that is broken, that can be fixed again. And the precious memories can never be taken.
Uh-oh. That's not a good face. Yes, plenty of time to read all my poem at this point. As the silence continues, my brain decides to fuck with me. What if she doesn't like it? What if she thinks it's about her? Will she be sad that I know that she feels that way? Or mad that I used the word broken? Damn it! She can probably see the worry on my face. Yes, Sayori, this poem, it's... Well, it's really good. This is to pause for a moment. But... It's just... What made you decide to write a poem like this? Huh? Damn, she knows something is up. What do you mean? Well, I was just expecting something cheesy or simple, maybe. Like roses are red, violets are blue. But this poem... She looks down and skims over my poem once more. It's really deep. So I was just wondering what made you come up with something like this. Since Sayori being serious is actually making me pretty nervous. Well... Come on, think. Say something that will put her at ease. The truth is, the poem was inspired by you. Huh? Damn, that was a horrible way to start. Well, I guess it's more accurate to say it was inspired by my time with you. Those feelings in the poem are mine, you know? I didn't notice that how I felt recently. Not until I spent time with you yesterday. Made me realize that I haven't been truly happy like that in a long time. I have to struggle to keep my voice from breaking. I suppose this poem is about how I want to repair the relationship between us so that we can both be happy again. Or happy more. I'm sorry if you don't like it. There's a moment of silence between us as we both try to compose ourselves. I'm... Suddenly, Sayori suddenly lunges forward and wraps her arms around me. Huh? I glance around the room to see if anyone is looking, but nobody seems to notice. I'm really glad you showed me your poem. I feel the same way. Once she releases her embrace, I can see that she cried on me a little. But I can tell from the smile on her face that she wasn't crying out of sadness. Thank you, Sayori, and I'm also really glad that I showed you the poem. And I meant what I said. Even though it wasn't what the poem was about. Maybe it was?
I don't think I've forgotten about reading yours.
Oh! She picks up her poem and looks it over. It's not as good as yours, though. If you're the one who wrote it, then I'm sure it's fantastic. Hands me the poem. It's still the same. I don't get it. It's the same one as the one she wrote last time. She told me that she wrote it when she got home yesterday. She wouldn't lie about something like that. Unless... I trust you too. Kissing my forehead. My heart stops as I reread the text line. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. Sleep forever. Do you like it? Maybe I'm overthinking this. Maybe it really is just a bug. Hello? Earth Lopsa? Huh? Oh, sorry, Sayori, I was just... really into your poem, you know. It's okay if you don't like it. What? Of course I like it. The way you paint such a vivid image of a beautiful sunny morning. It's very Sayori-ish. Sayori-ish. Sorry. I hope that's all it is. Just a painting of a sunny morning. I hand Sayori her poem back and begin putting mine back in the folder. Hey, Lopsa, about that poem you wrote. I was wondering if I could... Of course you can have it, silly. Oh, but what about the others? I have some drafts that I can show them. Don't worry about it.
Thanks.
I'm gonna write the best poem ever for tomorrow, so you better be ready. I look forward to it, my lady. Well, I guess that just leaves Monica. I've been dreading this moment. Which one should I show her? I put a folder and thumb through the poems. Since I left Sayori keep... Yes, I'll have Yuri's and Natsuki's. Yuri seemed to like hers a lot, but it's hard to tell with Natsuki. Let's see, how should I do this? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. My highly sophisticated selection process lands me with Yuri's poem. I hope she doesn't think that I want Yuri or something. Not that I don't want her. Ah! Having a good time so far? Yeah, I can't say I'm not enjoying myself. Good, glad to hear it. Oh, I remember that if... blah blah blah. Wait a minute. Did you just... And with that out of the way, you can show me your poem now. Damn, she's going a mile a minute. Maybe he just really wants to read what I wrote. Sure thing, Monica, here you go. I can feel my anxiety building as she reads my poem. I can't tell if she likes it or not. What I do is she doesn't. I'm still not sure how to go about writing for her. Hopefully this will be good enough until I... Huh? The serious expression on Monica's face doesn't help much in easing my worry. Yes, Monica? Well, I'm having a bit of a trouble with this poem. Could you tell me about the feelings it's trying to convey? Having trouble? There's no way she wasn't able to see the message. Now, what was it that Yuri said? It's about the feeling of being trapped or never being able to get what you desire. I see, and would you mind telling me about the inspiration behind it? Inspiration? The hell? How did this turn into an interrogation all of a sudden? Well, you see... Yep, I totally understand. What? I didn't say anything? And I really liked your poem. It's nice to read something that isn't just a bunch of jumbled words. Jumbled words? Is she talking about the other girl's poems? Does she not like them? Anyway, here's mine. I hope you like it. Yep, it's still the same. As I read Monica's writing, I become increasingly lightheaded. Why do I feel like this? It's just a poem. Why am I dizzy all of a sudden? A hole, looking out, the other side. So, what do you think? I thought it was a lot like mine. The fuck? I thought it was a lot like mine. Do you feel trapped, Monica? What did you see on the other side? I thought it was really good. Are you alright? What? What is going on with her? Is everything okay? You look kind of pale. Yeah, I was just spacing out a little. If that's the way I look when I space out, it's no wonder Sayori gets so concerned. It's like she saw a ghost. Thanks for sharing. I can't wait to see what you come up with tomorrow. Sure. Before I can finish speaking, Monica turns around and walks off. What the actual fuck just happened? She even left her poem. I pick up the paper she left behind and place it in the folder of mine. I thought after our talks today, yesterday, things would be good between us. But maybe she does secretly hate me. Sigh. Damn it.